because they are all invested in the same dynamic outcome. They all want $25 million from the Saudis for their library. They all want those deals that exist. And if somebody else takes over the shop and looks at those books and looks at those deals, what do you think is going to happen? Now, Barack Obama, and there's always this sick, disgusting, depraved romanticism about the idea of him being harmed by the left. The left's always saying, oh, somebody's going to kill him. Somebody's going to kill him. The person I think most in danger is Sarah Palin. I would hope that this woman has a certain kind of security that is visible and aggressive. Barack Obama has the best in the world, and he's had the best in the world. But it is people who, on the left, who tend to shoot at people in politics, certainly in this country. And now with even more at stake than some loony left-wing nut job getting all lathered up because of what's going on the left. When you've got the entire machine sees you as a threat, well, who's to know? So I'm going to hope, and I know that certain people listen to the show, look, security has got to be paramount. And I'm going to trust that she knows this, because this is a campaign. Whatever she ends up doing with it, I don't know, but I like it. And the longer she's out in front, the more she serves as a juxtaposition of what should be happening with others in, it's just like with New York's 23rd. Forcing Plenty to come out.
A couple of key things. Number one, I think that we've restored America's standing in the world, and that's confirmed by polls. I think a recent one indicated that around the world, before my election, less than half the people, maybe less than 40% of the people, thought that you could count on America to do the right thing. Now it's up to 75%. That builds goodwill among publics that makes it easier for leaders to cooperate with us.
A prince on the bridge of a castle moat heard lay, odle, odle,
ho. Men on a road with a load to tote heard lay, odle, odle.
We're out of money now.
Men in the midst of a toppled dote heard lay, odle, odle, ho.
Men drinking beer with a foam afloat heard lay, odle, odle.
Welcome to the Tammy Bruce Show. She's a chick with a gun and a microphone. And now, Tammy Bruce.
The following program is closed captioned for the thinking impaired.
Here with you. Yes, indeedy. Our lonely goat herd moment for today was Barack Obama explaining how our standing in the world's improved because polls show it. That's right. Every time he bends over, that is exactly the way the world wants America, is bent over. That is why everyone so much loved us when we got nailed on September 11th and then got mad again when we stood up for ourselves. That's right. It's just like when cockroaches just hate you when you turn the light on. When you leave the light off, they love you. Yeah. Our condition of life cannot be left to a world that without us would have killed itself a long time ago. It's like worrying about what the Manson family thinks of you. Oh, I'm sure they have their moments now that they're in prison and that there's nobody to kill and they can't get their hands on weapons. But really, if left to their own devices, once again, and we're going to care about what they think of us. See, that's been the problem all along. is the presumption, when you just look historically at the rest of the world, that these, look, we've just wanted to be left alone all the time, and they kind, they come and get us. We are forced to be involved in the crack house of the rest of the world because they're dangerous children who are running with scissors. If you asked all the children in the world what they thought of Daddy when Daddy told them no, they'd hate him. You have a problem in a household when the five-year-old is just fine with everybody. Usually that five-year-old is coloring on the walls and throwing food and defecating other than in the toilet and hurting the pets because Daddy is nice, but his standing is certainly been restored because they love Daddy. You're living in hell on earth, but boy, Daddy sure is loved because he lets him eat the ice cream at night for dinner. Ridiculous standard. And the rest of the world admits that as well. You've got a rest of the world that has to pass laws for itself to not let the Nazis come up. You know what? We can't see the swastika because we don't know what we're going to do if it comes back because we can't stop ourselves. If the Germans had any self-respect and the prohibition against free speech, and the only time free speech matters, as we know, is when people might be upset by it. If nobody was ever going to be upset, you wouldn't need issues regarding free speech. But it is still illegal to have the swastika or whatever in Germany. Why? Because the Germans aren't sure. They're not sure. European Union? Constitution? It's a crime to offend somebody. What are you so afraid of? What are you? Well, you know, they know their own history. It is a history of war for conquest. It is a history of genocide. And they sit there and point fingers at the United States of America. Oh, our standing in the world's better. That's a worry. That is a worry. When our standing was horrible, funny enough, it's when Germany elected Merkel and France elected Sarkozy, two conservatives. Ooh, and the standing was awful. Maybe the standing amongst liberals was awful. You know what? They can go suck an egg at this point. That's exactly all that they're going to be able to do. Look, next time, like when there's a tsunami, you know, with the horrible tsunami in Indonesia, America, we as individuals were the largest donors of aid to that nation after the tsunami. America as a country and as individuals, we are the largest donors to the Muslim world and Indonesia, which is a Muslim country, not Saudi Arabia, none of these other fabulously rich Islamic pits, the United States of America. Here's what the rest of the world has to be worried about. We have no money anymore. We're spent out. What the hell are you going to do with all those socialist countries which have never had any money? What are you going to do now? God help you when there is a tragedy and we're broke.